Hello.
Hello.
How are you doing? Nice to meet you. I'm Alex.
My name's Michael.
Good to meet you, Michael. What brings you to the wood?
Oh, what brings me here is a story that I want to tell you.
Okay.
About, how can I say it, a great mentor to me.
Okay.
And his name is Coach Hess.
Coach Hess.
Yeah, but everyone calls him Master Coach Hess.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, because he knows his stuff about basketball.
Like, okay.
He used to play way back in the days when he was 14.
Mm-hmm.
He had to give up because of his knees, but he didn't just give up, but he put loads back into the community, coaching young kids and mentoring young kids, just like myself.
Okay, so he coached you basketball as well?
Yeah, so I got put on a holiday program in, I'll say, like the meanest part in North London.
Okay, so it's a bit of a rough area where maybe kids don't get these sorts of opportunities.
Yeah. And like, if no one's there to supervise them, they won't go there. So that's okay. Why he's the godfather of the court to
okay.
Make sure everything runs smooth.
Everyone knows Coach Hess, so I guess has he been in that area for a long time?
Yeah, he's the one even before it was even basketball courts, it used to be tennis courts, and obviously no one used to use it. So they sat down with the council, the mayor of Haringey, and they turned it into a lovely basketball court.
Oh, wow. So he started the entire thing from absolute scratch.
Yeah.
What a guy. And then I guess it's, you know, one of those areas where if they don't have a program like this, the life of the kids could be very different.
100%, definitely.
So what would you like us to do for him?
There's a chair he brings along, and I think over the 10 years, it's coming to its days. So I think we should make him a brand new chair.
A new chair for
with
him.
Master Coach Hess at the back,
Master
engraved.
Master Coach Hess, all right, okay.
They see that chair and they know who's there. The one he's got now is like a foldable plastic one, but I think
he deserves better.
Yeah, definitely.
He needs a throne.
That's the word I was looking for.
Yeah.
Definitely.
I cannot wait to make something for Coach Hess. He sounds
I
like an amazing man.
Thanks
for coming, Michael. Leave it with me. I'll see what I can do for
Lovely.
You.
Lovely. Thank you.
Take care.
Bye.
So Michael wants a special chair for a special guy, and I think I've got something special in mind. But it's ambitious, to say the least.
I suppose you can't do like a camping chair, can you? I don't think it does it justice.
No.
What are you thinking?
Thinking Syrian chair.
A Syrian chair is more complicated than a camping chair, and I think more beautiful. The main difference being it has four access points as opposed to just two or three. This includes a seat, which has a hinge in the middle of it, and means the whole thing folds together more intricately.
So all I need to do is make sure I pick the right timber. Start trying to work on all these angles.
Good luck with that.
Cheers.
With no time to lose and with sustainability in mind, I've selected some timber that would otherwise have gone to waste.
I've been on the scrounge around the workshops and claimed everybody's offcuts. Now, there's times where offcuts like this can end up in the fire pile, but these are diamonds in the rough. What I need for my folding chair is lots of small pieces of timber to create a big structure. I've got Iroko, Sapele, oak, ash. But if you sandwich two pieces of timber together, it's actually stronger than one piece of timber on its own. The crossing the grains, any weaknesses are countered by the strength in the other piece. I've never made one of these before, but I'm quite confident that in this case, we're gonna have something that works smooth and is very practical for Coach Hess to use.
Having already shaped my timber offcuts for Coach Hess's folding chair, my next job is to try and figure out how it's actually going to fold.
What I've got here are the pieces that are going to make up my back, and it's five pieces of timber. We've got oak, two pieces of sapele, and two pieces of ash. Now, the reason they're stuck together is I've been cutting them and shaping them on the bandsaw and sanding them. They need to be exactly the same shape as each other. Now that I've got that shape, I can take them apart again. Once I knock them apart, I know that these are all right, and as long as I've put a hole and a bar in the right place for my mechanism, it'll run perfectly smooth. Eee. It may look a bit crazy to put something together and take it apart, but the basic reason is it's a very complicated mechanism that I need to get working, so it's about locking it up with clamps and timber and seeing how it looks in terms of scale, angles. What I'm really hoping is all the bits I've cut actually fit together. I'm checking it actually looks like a half-decent piece of furniture. I think that's pretty cool. Now, after hours of messing about, I've finally got this scissor mechanism to work. If I lift up my chair now, it folds in the new area, and it's nice and tight. That way, it can fit in Coach Hess's boot in between his games, and when he's ready to sit down, folds it down and takes a seat. That is a success.
But there's one more very important detail to add.
The final bit is this back section with his name on. That'll be on the back, obviously, so everyone knows where he is when he's sat there. I'll glue this in, give it a polish, and it's ready to give back to Coach Hess.
Michael came to the woods to ask me to make a personalised chair for his basketball coach. Now he's back, and this time, Coach Hess is with him.
Michael, welcome back.
Nice to be back.
And you must be Coach Hess.
This is the famous guy.
It is the famous guy. Michael, why don't you tell us why you brought Coach Hess here today?
All right, here's the man himself. Well, we all started 10 years ago when I got introduced into a summer program. Back then, I was a shy, nervous guy, but as soon as I came into his gracious arms, boy, I picked up so much confidence and never stopped smiling. I say, on behalf of everyone, the little kids, the grown adults, people that's been there way before me and people that's been there during my time, that you've been a great inspirational role model, a great leader, and a great person to be around. You taught us so much, and it's time to give a little gift from our heart.
That's lovely.
Definitely.
That is lovely. I'm honoured with that, because some of that is like just me growing up in the community, you know?
Yeah.
And, you know, being a mentor for them. It's a hard knuckle area.
Right then. This is what I made for, and I gotta say, it's been an honour to make it for you, Coach.
Wow.
Yay!
Jeez! I love that. I got some chairs at home, but this beats all of them. And especially like on the rickety chairs, but this looks solid.
Have a little stroke.
There's no coach in the land that's going to have that.
You're right.
No coach.
And then if you ever want to take it in the car, you just give it a lift and it can pop away in the boot.
Nice. And Mike knows how important that is to me now, getting on the courts.
Yeah, and there's one little thing on the back for you as well. A little bit of privacy. A little bit of personal touch. Master Coach S.
Master! And funny enough, only this year I said to him, you know, head coach, but master now.
Master Coach S.
I've been 50 years in the game. When I take this out now, you know, and they want to sit, some of the youngers want to sit, I just say, hold on. Yeah. Who's the master coach? Yeah. Get off my chair, man. Thank you very much. Hey, beautiful! Beautiful! Oh man, top dollars, man. Yeah. Slam dunk.
You know,
it's a slam dunk, you know?
I'm just over the moon, like, he got everything down to the T. The chair looks amazing. The way it folds up is amazing. And obviously the right at the back, Master Coach Hess. Written right across the back. Wow.
To be honoured with this, you know, I'm lost for words. I'm just thinking, I'm really, really proud. A chair of that caliber can be made for me. That was just so nice.
I will never forget that moment. Giving that chair to Coach Hess was an absolute joy. To see Coach Hess's reaction, I'd make him 100 of these chairs.
I know the kids are gonna just laugh and love it. And when they look at that, they're gonna say, wow, wow! Where did you get that from? We ain't got one. Master! Yeah, the Master Coach Hess is in the house! Right?
Yep. That's right.